I'm Dr. Amy Benn, and I wanted to go over with you the time in which you should hold your stretches. I've been guilty as well of only stretching for short durations of time when I've had certain areas pulled or not, or feeling tight on my body. And it was brought to my attention recently that we really need to hold these stretches longer so that the body's muscles can really be educated, or you're training your body to open up. And when we're only doing 20 and 30 second stretches for elongating muscles, it's not enough time, and the muscles aren't getting the message, and they're not going to sustain the stretch. So it's important, whatever you're stretching, that you do hold it. If you're having a particular issue, if you're having an area that you really want to work through, and it's not loose on you right now, and you're really working on one side, for instance, the psoas muscle, you want to hold that stretch for more than 20, 30 seconds. Let it have a full minute. Let it have a full 90 second time duration to really get the neurological connection to your brain, to the brain muscle conduction, so that your body can actually open and receive the benefit of the stretch. So don't be in a big hurry when you're in pain and when you have a muscle to stretch. The more the merrier. So do stretch it a little bit longer than 20 or 30 seconds. Go ahead and hold some of these stretches for 90 seconds, especially if you have one side being tight and one side loose. I'm Dr. Amy Benn. If you have any more questions, give me a call, or thank you.